People who actually grabbed a baseball bat slash kitchen knife slash golf club and went to investigate that weird noise at night. What happened? My sister lives alone in a kind of nice, older apartment building. She was asleep just after 2 a.m. and she started hearing someone ducking with her front door. She grabbed her iron skillet and went to the door. Standing right behind it at the ready, she was like a ninja. Crouched in the darkness with the old iron above her shoulder holding the handle with both hands. Scrape scrape. Fiddle fiddle. Curse as he hits the door with his fist. The old building's solid core doors didn't budge. Another minute of aggressive ducking with the lock and suddenly it stopped. Silence. She tensed ready for the intruder to just kick the door in. Then from the other side of the door she heard oh. Whoops. Fuck. And her neighbor turned from her door and put his key in his door. He'd finally figured out in his drunken stupor why his key wasn't working. Now she keeps a softball bat by her bed because apparently holding the skillet was really tiring. That mfer is heavy. I once grabbed the baseball bat as I kept hearing very weird sounds that was making the dogs go berserk. When I came out there was 3 coyotes harassing the hell out of the neighbor's outside dog. Nipping him the ass. All kinds of shit. So I went back inside. Grabbed the air horn. Came back out. The coyotes left. But I also woke up the whole neighborhood. Our parents' bedroom was in the basement and this was long before cell phones. So we had no way to contact them when something started bumping around loudly all over the living room in the dark. My oldest sister wasn't it a take charge person. So with her leading, clutching a baseball bat, we followed closely behind her single file to face the danger. With a roar, she leaped to the light switch. So that our first sight was her brandishing the bat like a mighty sword over Fonzie, our hamster, whom another sister had forgotten, was rolling around the house in his plastic ball. We have a little bell hanging from our back door handle. We use it to train puppies how to go outside to pee. Teach them to hit the bell with their nose when they want the door open to pee. Anyway, I wake up to it gently jingling like someone was trying to slowly turn the doorknob without raising alarm. We had no puppies in our care at the time. Went down to investigate, and it was our damned cat. As soon as he saw me, he sat down waiting expectantly that I would open the door same way I do the puppies. Lol. It was the ducking cat. As I was walking holding an iron rod, I looked behind and saw my mom with a hammer and I couldn't stop thinking how funny it was, but we found nothing at all. Woke up one night after hearing gunshots. So I went outside, 38 in hand, to find my neighbor popping off shots from his handgun, trying to get people's attention because his kitchen was on fire. Ironic. I was a firefighter back then. This was in 1987 or 88, and he didn't have access to his telephone. When I was a student, I was alone in the house that I shared with 5 other guys. They were all at home or with girlfriends for the weekend. It was about 2 a.m. and I was in bed reading when I heard someone downstairs. Not a noise, that could be someone, but definitely 100% someone. My room was on the second floor, a converted attic room with no way out apart from down the steep narrow stairs with a door at the bottom, then a landing to cross, and then another flight of stairs to the hall with the door to the outside. We had been burgled twice before while we were away, and a local female student had been tied up by burglars and not found for a while. I was shitting myself. I'd always thought that if I was faced with intruders I'd show them who was boss, but I was terrified and frozen with indecision. I had a long metal bar, but who knew what the burglar or burglars had? Knives? Not guns as this is UK, but still. Should I lock my door? It only had a feeble bolt. Easily broken and surely feed wonder what was in a locked room. This was 1990. So no mobiles. The phone was, of course, downstairs. Should I shout out of the window for help at 2 a.m.? There was no one to shout to. Should I charge down and scare the duckers? Feet probably just overpower me. I stood at the top of my stairs, dithering, not knowing what to do. Then footsteps started coming up the first flight of stairs. Shit. Then they crossed the hall towards my stairs. Double shit. The door opened. My housemate Marco popped his head into the doorway. "Alright, John. I've come back early." I nearly punched the bastard in my relief. He didn't understand why I was so upset. Didn't sleep for a few hours. Weeeeel. Back in 98, when I was a young teenager, one night my dog started barking, which was very odd, since he was usually quiet. He was standing at the back door, staring at it and barking. So I went to my room, and picked up one of my Katniss, yay angsty teen, and went to the back door and opened it. There was a guy in a prison uniform in my backyard, trying to hide from the police. He saw me, saw my katana, and ran, which is good, because I wouldn't have been able to actually fight him off if he'd come at me. Something to know about my house at that time: I was literally two doors down from the county jail. It was a really tiny town with a sparse population. The jail has since been moved out of a residential area. Lol. Was her abandoned cat. Now she lives with us for 6 years. And her name is Lyra. My brother grabbed a baseball bat and hid with my mom and I in her bedroom. He let our two pit bulls loose inside the house and called the cops. They showed up within 2 minutes. It was 2 a.m. on a weekend. Shined a helicopter light into our backyard and brought dogs. Some guy was trying to break in through the backyard, spare room window facing the yard, next to the back door, and my brother heard it, because he was awake. I'm glad he was there to catch it. I'm not sure what would have happened otherwise. We don't live in a particularly safe neighborhood, but it could be worse. Also, I don't even know why he let our dogs loose inside the house. When they are so docile and baby, he'd probably just make the burglars some tea and ask if he'd like to sit down. I was a teenager and I and my sister were home alone because my mom and stepdad were at the bar again. We were in the living room and heard the outside door leading to the utility room and back porch area open. The hinges were squeaky. At first, we thought it was the wind. But then we heard footsteps. We heard them try the doorknob and could see it jiggle a bit. I ran into my mom's bedroom and grabbed one of the guns and brought it back out with me. Then hollered out that I was going to count to I can't remember if it was 3 or 10. And then I was going to open the door and shoot. I started counting out loud. And we could hear whoever it was run back down to the outer door and leave. I finished counting and unlocked the door, then yanked it open. The outside door was hanging open. But the person was gone. Called the bar and asked to talk to my mom. She got on the phone and I told her what happened and asked her if I should call the cops. She said no and that they would be home in an hour or so when it was last call. Yeah, my mom and stepdad sucked. 17 years ago, I got up to pee around 3 a.m. Saw someone in my front yard through the blinds. Went to pee. Then the car alarm starts going off. Grabbed my shotgun and went out front. Cold and find anybody. About 5 minutes later it happens again. Check the front yard and backyard. Cold and find anybody. So I sit in the house with the lights off looking through the blinds. Can't see the car due to my truck blocking it. After about 15 minutes I go out front. Some third occur is in the car. So I'm there about 10 feet away with a shotgun pointed at him. He is yelling at me to shoot him. Turns out it was my girlfriend's ex-fiance. Long story short, I held him at gunpoint until the cops show up. I got put in handcuffs at gunpoint. He gets Baker acted. I get let go because they realized I wasn't the bad guy, lol. The owner of the house came in, slash, landlords. Criminals. What's the difference anyways? The holes in their heads. It was my mom's boyfriend coming over to drop off coffee and breakfast for us as a surprise for when we woke up in the morning. I was home alone for the first time since we got married because my wife had just given birth to our first child. I came awake to a weird skittering noise and went down the stairs to investigate. Halfway down I realized that it was some helium balloons that my mill had dropped off. They had found their way to the stairway ceiling and joggled their way up. I was relieved but then had the thought that something must have made them move. So after going through the whole house with a baseball bat to make sure, I realized that it must have been the hot air from the furnace. I'm not a smart person. Usually nothing. Once, though, two guys scaled our fence. We think they had actually tried to break into the neighbors and were fleeing through our yard. These days, I'll let the dogs out and come out with a flashlight and a club or machete. So far, nothing. I learned I have obsessive compulsive disorder. There was never anyone there. Never anything other than my imagination and spiking fear. But if I didn't clear the apartment just right, then I was certain the intruder would have snuck from a place I hadn't checked to a place I had, and I'd have to start over and do it again. Definitely spent at least an hour doing this in a 500 square foot apartment once. This isn't actually what got me diagnosed with OCD. But the first time I did it after the diagnosis, I was like, "Ooh, that's what this is." Still did it. Hard compulsion to beat. Hasn't come up since, so I haven't really had a chance to see if I have the nerve to try an exposure with it. We were kids at my friend's house. I think around 10 years old. Home alone. Dog started barking wildly, so we grabbed some firewood and went to the door. Opened it and there was a massive package at front of the door. I think her dad ordered a car bumper or something big and the postman just put it there without ringing the doorbell. I almost knocked out my husband coming home late after a concert with his brothers. He got too drunk to drive home. So he left his car at his brother's house. In his intoxicated state, he forgot his phone in his brother's car. I woke up around 3 a.m. Concert was over before midnight. They went to eat afterward. I noticed husband wasn't home yet. Looked out front, no car. I tried calling his phone and no answer. I heard a noise downstairs. So I grabbed a bat and headed downstairs in the semi-dark. Standing in the living room in his underwear, mud all over, and drunk was my husband. He is 6 feet 9 tall. I thought he was an intruder. Side note, on that day a guy got arrested in the next town over for breaking slash entering and raping a woman who was by herself. We laugh about it now, and we state this incident on why we don't own a gun. Please subscribe and leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more of Reddit Universe.